Greetings, friends. We are live, and GB is here. And hey, Toast, what's up? Well, first things first, friends, I do have to, I have to apologize. I didn't realize how late it is. It's like really late. I was playing Mario Kart online with some friends, and I guess the night just got away from me. So yeah, Toasters, I am very grateful for those of you who are here, like Rabbit and K Epiphany and Sergio Ruiz Jr. So yeah, awesome that you guys are here, and we are going to be doing a cool unboxing today. And oh yes, my mustache is still missing. Let me know if you see it anywhere. Yeah, we're going to be doing a cool unboxing today of the Sonic Totaku figures. Now, of course, they did make Sonic, and then GameStop exclusives, Knuckles and Tails. I don't know if you guys had this problem like I did, but every GameStop I went to had Knuckles and Tails only. I guess Sonic was shipped separately because he's not a GameStop exclusive. So, like, I've been sitting on Knuckles and Tails for, like, weeks, and I just barely got Sonic, like, 2 days ago. So, yeah, we are finally going to get these things open and, yeah, see how groovy they are. So, let's jump into it, friends. As I adjust the camera, since we're live, I can't edit this. But I'm going to lower the camera like so as I flip the picture. All right. So we're going to unbox them right here in front of this picture of Dr. Robotnik as he's yelling stuff. This is actually a, animation cell of Dr. Robotnik. So, yep, let's just fix the light a little bit, get some light going there, and we'll start with Sonic. Now, these boxes are nice, but it looks like there's like a smaller box within the box. We're not going to cut it like we do with Amiibo. We're just going to tear it off just because I say so. Anyway, as we get this open, do you guys believe 1 week from right now we are going to be playing Super Smash Bros. Ultimate? Yeah, right now. Because GameStop is releasing it Thursday night. My GameStop says be there at 10 p.m. 10 p.m. So, yeah. It's way past 10 p.m. where I live, so I'll be playing Smash Bros. Ultimate at this time. Alright, I totally can't get this Sonic out. It's like this box within the box here. Let's see. French onions. Ah, finally got him. Okay, so, tore that up nice. Oh, look, it's got a profile on the back. Let's see, year of release, 1991. First appearance, Sonic the Hedgehog. Fastest hero, blue spikes, cool attitude. Sonic spins head into trouble to defeat the evil forces of Dr. Eggman. All right, so, here is the figure. So, first things first, I do like this little, look at this. 16-bit background it comes with. This is fantastic. This little box that says Sonic on it, you know I'm keeping this for sure. Now as for the figure itself, look, it opens up just like an Amiibo. And let's see here. Let's take that off. Wow. Here we go. So here is the Sonic Totaku figure. And unlike Amiibos that have round stands, Totakus have these plus-shaped stands. This one has 16-bit blocky grass, a blocky-looking ring that's very flat there. Sonic is doing his signature pose. You know what this reminds me of? Give me one sec as I go grab something. This reminds me just of the Kid Robot set of Sonic figurines. So this is the Kid Robot Sonic in the exact same pose. You can see them both here. The Kid Robot one is a little bit bigger. Of course, this is from a blind box, so you can't even choose which one you're getting. Overall, looking at the two side by side, even though Kid Robot is bigger, I think the Totaku one looks better. His eyes look less wonky, I think, on Totaku. And then also, let's see, the Kid Robot one, Sonic's foot kind of squishes at the bottom, which is just fine. Totaku, Sonic's foot just sort of Oh, it also squishes, but it looks like it just blends into the grass better. Yeah, overall, I do think the Totaku one looks a little bit better, in a little bit better shape. Not to say the Kid Robot one is bad in any way. They are just fine. They are groovy. But both of them, I think, are still better than the Sonic Amiibo. So, yeah. That is that. Let's lower the camera a little more here so we can see our Sonics. Like so. Okay. Next up, we are doing everybody's favorite sidekick in the entire world, Tails. Now this one, again, is a GameStop exclusive. I don't know where else they actually sell Totaku figures besides GameStop. And tell you the truth, I'm kind of excited that Totaku is doing Sonic characters. I thought Totaku was only doing PlayStation characters at first, and Sonic is not really much of a PlayStation character. Yeah, he's had a handful of games on PlayStation. But yeah, anyway. So, again, just like Sonic, he comes with the exact same Green Hill Zone background. Still cool. Still cool. And this one says Tails, of course. And now, the figure itself. Oh, Sports! He came right off of his stand. Where did Tails go? One sec while I go find him. French onions, toast, hippos. Okay, one sec. Okay, sorry about that, friends. Here is Tails. Okay, so yeah, he does come off of his stand. He's got this clear pole coming out of his crotch. What is that supposed to be, Tails? Is that your catheter? That's really weird. Let's see here. Okay, so it looks like I broke him out of the box because that is not supposed to come out. It is broken. So, let this be a warning to everyone who gets this figure. It does just kind of snap right off as I was taking the plastic off. I'm actually kind of sad and disappointed. I really am. I'll have to fix this later off camera because this kind of stinks. French toast. Yeah. Well, we could still look at the sculpt of the figure. He looks really good. He's up in the air as if he's flying. This reminds me of another Kid Robot figure, which is this Tails, which is flying, which I like how Kid Robot has a more in the propeller kind of state with their flying pose. Overall, I still think Totaku is the better sculpt on Tails' face and head. Both good figures, though. Both good figures. Yeah, one sec, as I'm now off camera and I'm gonna try to stick the pole back in, but no, it is just totally broken. Yeah, it is snapped. It does not go back in. French onions, boy, that's disappointing. Now I just have this Tails with this big old like wiener pole thing here. Lame bears. That is majorly lame bears. So, let that be a warning to everyone. Be careful when unboxing your Tails. Anyway, here we go. Knuckles. Knuckly Knuckles. Let's see. 1994. First appearance. Sonic the Hedgehog 3. Oh, we didn't look at Tails' profile. As it says, 1992. First appearance. Sonic the Hedgehog 2. Which is accurate. Alright. Well, anyway. Knuckly Knuckles. Hopefully we have better luck with him. All right. Here we go. Here is Knuckles. All right, just like Sonic and Tails, we once again have the Green Hill Zone background. So, that is another positive. Okay. All right, got Knuckles out without breaking anything. So, here we go. Knuckles, unlike Sonic, he's got a little Chaos Emerald here, which is like a full-on sculpted emerald, which is different than Sonic, who had the 8-bit flat ring. So that's Interesting, different style we got here. And Heinbro Gaming is asking if I'm reading comments, and yeah, I'm kind of seeing them as they're scrolling by, but just not answering them because I guess I'm just tired. Anyway, Toasters, here we go. I should actually, you know, respond to your comments because you guys are being here watching this with me, so I'll do better, my friends. Samuel L. Jackson is saying, where's my super suit? Anyway, looking at Knuckles. Now, one advantage Totaku has is that Kid Robot did not make a Knuckles, which was pretty messed up. So Totaku is one of the few companies that has made a classic Knuckles, along with Tomy and a couple others. So yeah, he looks just fine. He looks, he actually looks really good for a classic Knuckles figure, and he seems a little bit big to me compared to Sonic, a little too big. Maybe that's why he looks so good, because he's so big. At the same time, he doesn't seem proportionate to Sonic and Tails. Sonic and Tails seem very proportionate to each other. Knuckles is too big. He's like, who's he think he is? Sonic Boom Knuckles? Toasters. Anyway, friends, so there we go. We have these three Sonic Totaku figures. Again, available at GameStop. Be careful with your tails. But what? Challenger approaching. Wee-oo, wee-oo. We got a Crash Bandicoot Totaku figure. So let's get this guy in box too. Now, I've had this thing for like a year almost, because I honestly thought Crash was going to be in Smash this time around. So that's why I got this. I also got the Crash Funko Pop. I got the Crash Skylander. Like, I had convinced myself that Crash would be in Smash Brothers. So yeah, now I have all this Crash Bandicoot merchandise that's like, most of it's still in the box. Anyway, but yeah, they do more Crash characters now. He comes with a cool background too. I like that about Totaku figures. Amiibo should do that. They should come with backgrounds. And yeah, they make a Golden Crash. I think they make Cortex. I know they make Coco for sure, his sister. But here's Crash, again, another fantastic sculpt. So these are like almost like the non-Nintendo amiibos, because they are just cool figures, cool display figurines of video game characters. Let's pull in a couple amiibos just to compare. So let's grab a couple here. Da, 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 da. All right, sports, hit the camera. So here's a couple amiibos. I just grabbed Inkling Boy, Donkey Kong, and Yoshi. And size-wise, you can compare Crash to Yoshi here. They're about the same. The Sonic ones are a bit smaller. But then again, the Smash Brothers ones like this are a bit smaller too. So yeah, I'd say they could probably, you can probably set them up with your amiibos and they blend in just fine. Oh wow, should we do that? Should we put these guys on the amiibo shelf and see how they look? That would be weird, wouldn't it? Toast. All right, here we go. Here we go. Onto the amiibo shelf. Sorry, I have to adjust the legs on my tripod first. Okay, here we go, friends. Sorry for the shakiness. It's always the problem with going live, is we don't get to edit the video. All right, thanks for bearing with me there. All right, so yeah, my amiibo shelf is kind of a mess right now because we got the Mario Rabbids figures on there, and the Mega Man 11 amiibo, and now these World Nintendo ones. So, yeah. Oh, yes, and Ronald Bevel noticed the Mighty the Armadillo poster in the background. Thank you for noticing that. Anyway, let's, got World Nintendo. We'll just close right now. We'll move Mega Man. All right, so, here we go. Amiibo! Sorry, Mario Rabbids was... Move you for a minute too. Sports. All right. Donkey Kong goes here. This Yoshi or this Inkling Boy goes there.
There's Yoshi.
Okay, so let's see. We got all these amiibo. If we were to put, like, Crash here, how's that look? I mean, we have Skylanders here already with these four. You know, amiibo, Skylander hybrid things. But if we were to go, like, over here, where we have all these animal-type amiibos, and we were to stick maybe a Knuckly Knuckles and a Sonicy Sonic there, how do those look, you guys? What do you think? Logan says he needs a Gene Simmons amiibo, so, yep. That's, it's just an idea. I guess they're not official amiibo, so maybe they don't deserve to be on the amiibo shelf, like the giant yarn Yoshi or the Super Mario cereal box. But, you know, do what you want to do. It's a free country. So, friends, thank you for tuning in tonight. Thank you for being here for this unboxing of Totaku figures. And really quick, we'll take three comments. Like Pug55 says, "Hey Toast, can I get a shout out?" Of course, Pug55. Shout out to you, my friend. K Epiphany says, "It's like an all-nighter at Richard Simmons' house." Yeah, an all-nighter at Richard Simmons' house. Rock and roll all night and party every day. Shout out to Corn Dog and to Blake Walker and to Ian Sweeney and to Chaos Sonic 25 and to Welsey Woodson and to Floppy Ness. Floppy Ness. Yeah, and Sergio Ruiz Jr. is here, and so is Samuel Jackson and High-End Bro Gaming. So, friends, thank you all for being here, and have a wonderful night, and think 1 week from now, we are playing Smash Brothers Ultimate. It's gonna be amazing. All right, goodbye.